Let's say you find a small security issue with the kubelet and you fix it. You've got your change ready to go. What happens when you type git push and hit enter? Actually, nothing happens. You have to click on a PR first. CICD, what does it mean?
I think
everyone makes up their own acronym.
CICD stands for continuous integration, continuous deployment, or some might say continuous delivery.
But for the point of this video, we'll scope it as continuous integration, continuous deployment.
CICD is important to any modern software project. It's what enables the addition of new code. Code is coming from hundreds of contributors from all over the world. From hundreds of repositories into a single project. It would be impossible to add any new features without CI/CD system.
When a developer or just anybody in the ecosystem notices that something isn't working quite right or they'd like to change something, they submit a pull request to propose that change.
What you first have to do is fork the upstream project that creates your local repository in your local GitHub. You create a separate branch because you want to separate out each task you're doing. You don't want to do everything in one branch, and that will just make everything more complex, basically. So now you have everything the upstream has, and now you can make your own changes. You want to update it, fix bugs, add features, whatever you want to do.
And then I'll push that branch up to my GitHub repo. From there, I can submit a pull request. So when you submit a pull request, it's your branch against an upstream branch.
You have to go on GitHub, where it can registers those changes, and you actually have to hit a button that says open a pull request. So first thing you want to do as a developer who's pushed code to a repository is to make sure all your tests are running. So initially you have some basic tests that run, like unit tests, validation tests, formatting tests. So basically you have like 15 tests running, and all of them have to be green before we go ahead and merge the PR.
It's a very lucky day if all of the tests pass on the first go. That usually never happens.
Basically, reviewers will not look at your code if they see tests are failing. That means something is definitely wrong in there.
So often you'll get a red X next to a test, and that tells you your test has failed. That leads you to digging into the logs and figuring out how your change broke the cluster. I might know that a test is flaky.
A flake is when a test doesn't do the same thing every time you run it. There's no way to guarantee that a test is always going to do the same thing. So you might look at a test that fails once a week, and that's a flake.
Oftentimes, what you think is a flake is a real issue, and something can merge and break everybody's environment. Because once a pull request is merged, that new environment becomes the test environment for everybody else.
Once the tests are passing, on the GitHub UI, they'll see that everything's green. And that's when they start looking for a code owner to actually approve their changes and make sure that the changes they're proposing, even if they're written well, are actually moving the project in the direction that the owners want.
You want to document your PRs pretty well. This just makes it easier for the reviewers who are looking at it to actually understand what you're trying to add in.
And if they're not, your pull request won't get merged.
In Kubernetes, when a pull request is being reviewed, oftentimes the reviewers are looking to see if the code is of good quality and whether it's written correctly.
But not everyone is going to always be happy with your code. People do things in different ways, right? So sometimes people will have tiny nits where like, oh, you could do this in this form instead or that form, and that is up to you whether you want to incorporate it or you want to stand your ground.
Right, why you made this pull request, what broke, how you fixed it. That just helps the community grow and learn.
And if we're happy with it, we usually like to have two reviewers at least review it and give a look good to me on the PR.
So you've submitted your PR, it got bounced back to you, you fixed it, and you've submitted it again, and it's passed all of its tests. Now what happens?
Once all the tests are green, it goes through an automatic tied merge kind of process. So you tell the bot that I'm happy, and let's merge this.
Well, wait.
You really don't want a human pushing the merge button.
So you don't want to do that manually. It does that whole automatic process.
So let's say your PR has finally been accepted. Now it's time to enter integration hell.
A lot of developers will talk about integration hell. If your pull request doesn't get merged quickly after you have your approvals, you could run into merge conflicts.
So GitHub has a very nice interface that tells you that these files are conflicting.
Somebody else created a change and it merged and it is in the same file that you were working. that would mean you would have to go back to your local environment.
And you pull in the changes from the upstream project.
Fix any conflicts. And that happens all of the time. You need to re-push your pull request and all of the tests need to start over.
It sort of like rewinds and puts all the new stuff and then puts your commit on top of that. So even if you started before all this new stuff that got in, it pushes that before any of yours goes on top.
It's essential to have a CI system managing that.
It is a huge complex infrastructure and a lot goes into maintaining this. So integration hell to me is when your CI/CD goes down.
Do you know it's worse than CI/CD being down? GitHub being down. Your PRs made it through the rough waters and finally arrived at the tranquil tide pool.
Once it's in the tide pool and I know it's merged, I'm very happy.
Tide looks at the ocean of available pull requests and it scoops passing pull requests into little pools to notice when they're passing all their tests and they're actually ready to merge. And then it makes sure that all the tests are up to date. And not only is any one pull request up to date with the latest version that it wants to merge into, but even together as a pool, they're all working together as well. And then Tide's able to merge either one or a couple, whichever ones are available from that pool.
CI/CD might sound intimidating, but actually not having CI/CD is intimidating. The business problem is what's actually complex, having hundreds of people working together on a single project. A sophisticated CI/CD system is actually the easiest way to facilitate hundreds of people working together to create a single project like Kubernetes.